us. I am Ayoade Adedeji Moses. I'm a clinical nutritionist, a nutritional consultant at Adidam's Nutrition Consult. In my last video, I talked about food allergy and food intolerance, the part one of the series. In the last video, I talked about what food allergy is and what food intolerance is. I talked about different types of food allergy that we have, and I talked about the symptoms that food allergy brings. Today, I'll be talking about food allergy and food intolerance, which is the second part of this series. Today, I'll be talking about the differences between food allergy and food intolerance. Many people confuse food allergy and food intolerance. Many people do not know the difference between food allergy and food intolerance. There are four major differences between food allergy and food intolerance. 1. Food allergy has to do with the immune system, while food intolerance has to do with the digestive system. 2nd difference between food allergy and food intolerance is food intolerance is more common to people than food allergy. At every stage of life, of human life, at one stage, many people have encountered food intolerance, which is different from food allergy. The third difference between food intolerance and food allergy is that consuming the smallest part of the food that triggers these unpleasant reactions will still trigger these after reactions for food allergy. But for food intolerance, when food are consumed, when the smallest part of this food causing these reactions are consumed for food intolerance, an individual's body system may be able to tolerate this. The fourth difference between food allergy and food intolerance is that food allergy can lead to a life-threatening condition known as anaphylaxis, which is a very dangerous immune reaction. But food intolerance cannot lead to a life-threatening condition. These are the four major differences between food allergy and food intolerance. Now, let's go to the different types of food intolerances that we have. 1, lactose intolerance. Lactose intolerance is for people that do not have enzyme that is necessary to break down or to digest lactose in milk. So for people that do not have this enzyme, they have lactose intolerance. 2nd type of food intolerance is gluten intolerance. Gluten is a protein that can be found in barley, wheat and rye. When people doesn't have the enzyme, the proteases that is necessary to break down gliadin in gluten, these people can be sensitive to the presence of gluten in food. So people react after they've consumed food that contains gluten. The third type of food intolerance that we have is caffeine intolerance. Most people are not able to excrete or to absorb and metabolize caffeine properly in their body system. So by this, they are sensitive and they have after reaction to products that contains caffeine. The fourth type of food intolerance that we have is salicylate intolerance. Salicylate is a naturally occurring chemical that is found in plants. This salicylate is the natural defensive mechanism that plants have to ward off invaders, natural invaders such as insects and diseases. So, salicylate is naturally occurring in plants. For some people, they are sensitive to salicylate or to food that contains salicylate. Consuming such food may give them after reactions or may trigger reactions in their body system. The fifth type of food intolerance is amine intolerance. Amine is present in a wide variety of food. Amine can be manufactured by bacteria during food storage and food processing. For people who can tolerate the presence of amine in food, this triggers after reactions in their body system. For example, histamine intolerance. For people that don't have the enzyme histamine-deamine oxidase and methyl transferase for breaking down histamine in the blood, they may have this may trigger after reactions in their body system. The sixth type of food intolerance is sulfite intolerance. Sulfite is a chemical that is used for preserving food and drinks. It is used to delay spoilage or browning effects in food. For people that have asthma, or living with condition of asthma, sulfite intolerance is more common with them. And other people that cannot tolerate sulfite in food products, this may trigger after reaction of consuming food that contains sulfite. The seventh type of food intolerance is fructose intolerance. People are having after reactions after consuming fructose. For them, fructose is not usually metabolized or absorbed in the small intestine. This fructose is moved to the large intestine, whereby the gut bacteria works on it to produce gas, and this may give digestive disorder for people that can't absorb fructose in their small intestine. So this triggers an after reaction. The eighth major type of food intolerance is food map intolerance. Food map stands for fermented oligodimonosaccharide polyols. These fermented oligodimonosaccharide polyols are usually found in the large intestine because it is useful for gut bacteria as fuel. Food maps are not usually absorbed in the small intestine. So for people that are intolerant of the presence of food maps in their food, in their food products, it may cause digestive disorders such as bloating and belching. Food intolerances are aspartame intolerance. Aspartame is an artificial sweetener. So there are some people that are intolerable of the presence of aspartame in either food or drinks. We also have egg intolerance. These are for people that are intolerant of egg whites. Monosodium glutamate intolerance. Monosodium glutamate is an artificial sweetener that is applied to food. There are some people that are intolerant of the presence of these products called monosodium glutamate. Also, we also have food coloring intolerance. That is the presence of food colorings in food. The general symptoms of food intolerances are vomiting, nausea, belching, heartburn, irritability, flatulence, itching of the body, and skin rashes. Though we also have other symptoms of food intolerances. When looking at the dietary management of food allergy and food intolerance, these are dietary management guidelines for people that suffer food allergy and food intolerances. 1. Keep a diary of food that is consumed and keep a record of symptoms that is seen after consuming such food product. 2. Ensure that you stop eating some certain food, which will help you in tracing out foods that triggers these reactions. 3. For enzyme-related food intolerances, e.g. lactose intolerance, take the needed enzyme supplements, or you should look for the food-free products. This will help in reducing food intolerances. For food allergies, 4, always try to eliminate or remove the food that is causing or that is triggering these after reactions. 5, always ensure to read food labels and look out for ingredients that may cause after reactions or that may trigger reactions. Number 6. Whenever you are eating outside, always ensure you ask the server how the food will be prepared, especially when ingredients will be added to main food products, so that you will know maybe the ingredients added to the food will not be the ones that will trigger after reaction after consuming it. You are what you eat. Thank you for viewing this video. I want you to like and share this video. Subscribe to this channel for more nutritional tips for elderly.